Hey Rhea, what's why is it that women won't assume responsibility? Ben lost a lot of weight, didn't he, man? No comment, huh? Been on the call. So, Rhea, we ask you again, why doesn't women like you kind of look like that lady that was in that video that Tazadak was playing. Why doesn't women like to assume responsibility?
Is that a trick question?
Yeah, it's a trick question. I mean, evil of the play, deranged. So I mean, evil of the play, stupid. So I play stupid. Yeah, it's a trick question. It's gonna trick you. So yeah, watch out for the trick now. Watch out for the trick. So the first thing I'd like to point out here is that everyone else responded to the question directly and attempted to answer it. Notice when Rhea was asked the question, she asked, "Was that a trick question?" So she automatically went on the defense. She had no intention of answering the question directly. And so people that have this kind of mindset have a tendency to believe that someone's always out to get them. It's just a basic question. In fact, it was the subject matter. Why do women not like to assume responsibility? So let's see how she responds to this. One thing that I've learned by studying psychology, when someone answers my question with a question, it's designed to try and set me up. Many people have actually come on here to try, but none has actually been successful. Now, everyone answered the question directly except for Rhea. Now, why do you think that is, Kadar? She's the only one that said, "Is that a trick question?" That means you're anticipating some sort of attack or some sort of comeback. It's just a general question.
Well, but I
Just a
mean,
general question.
it's an accusation framed as a question, though.
It's not an accusation, it's a question. You're saying we're making an accusatory statement, but we have a sister that's given validity. I could give plenty of validity of women that don't want to assume responsibility. They tap dance around it. They give excuses. And essentially, excuses is just basically telling you all the reasons that someone's going to fail. Because until you address the merit of it's not going to happen. So, again, I mean, should I ask that question in Mandarin and you'll think it's not a trick?
I mean, I don't agree that women don't take accountability.
Okay, why not?
I just know women that do take accountability,
But we
like.
don't mean all women. You
Okay.
have Crystal up top that said, she, not all women. I mean, so when people talk, they talk like that. Why don't men do this? We don't mean all men, but a high percentage of women don't seem to assume responsibilities for. Let me give you an example of what I'm talking about. We had maybe four women on here last week, and we asked them why the relationship ended, and miraculously, it seemed to always be the man's fault that the relationship ended. The relationship ended because of something that he did. But
Okay.
she was not at fault. Essentially, what she was saying is she was reacting to his bad behavior on every given case. Even Sharon, when she came on, it was always something the man did. No accountability. No account. If I'm wrong about something, I'm going to say, okay, I'm going to wear that. It's mine. I own that. Okay, I did it. Now I can move on. I could grow. But when someone say, well, I did this because, yeah, well, you did this, there's no growth in that.
I think it's probably just has to do with like a difference in ways of communicating things. Like men tend to be really aggressive, you know, when they're bringing up stuff. And so, you know, obviously that would make somebody feel defensive, you know, rather than wanting to try to figure out a solution.
If we listen to people talk carefully, they're generally telling you who they really are. And what Rhea is doing right now, she's telling us who she is. She's telling us that she doesn't like to assume accountability, that she likes to tap dance around the truth. See, there's a blame game going on right here. She's saying in her attempted justification is that the reason that women don't accept responsibility is because men talk to them aggressively. But as you will witness in this video for yourself, she's exposed to be a liar because I spoke very calmly to Sharon and she still did not assume any responsibility in her actions for being belligerent on my show that night. So let's let this proceed. And this is why women like Rhea will always generally end up with an independent mindset and generally end up alone. These type of women could get penis appointments, but just can't keep that permanent man. And the men that they attract are the men that's going to actually literally cater to them, kiss up to them, and generally the men that they don't want. But no man of status or any kind of alpha male would actually be able to sustain a prolonged relationship with this type of woman. She doesn't want to assume accountability, and she's very combative without even realizing it. See, the sad case here is that many of these women do not even realize their own fallacies and realize that we're here to help because they go into defense mode. And this is a pattern that's been developed throughout their lives, and a habit is a difficult thing to break.
Well, hold on. You say men are aggressive when they bring things up?
Yeah.
Are you absolutely sure about that?
Yes.
Because I presented things to people in a very calm manner, and there's still no responsibility assumed. Sometimes they just tap dance around the truth. They have an expectation, right? For somehow it seems as though they believe that they could read your mind, right? Like they could peer into your mind, but when you ask them what they're thinking, they can't seem to answer that. But they're assuming that you're thinking a particular thing when you're really not. So do you concur with that, Kadar? That men are too aggressive. That's why women don't assume responsibility.
Not at all. From what I know from my experiences and observing women, women more so lean towards their emotions, and their emotions block them from thinking logically. Because if you listen to most women, they won't say, well, I think this. They more say, I feel. So that's a key indication that they always moving off of their emotions.
Yashabin, what do you think about that? What do you think about Rhea's accusatory statement that men acts too aggressively, and so that excuses a woman for assuming, basically, is what she said.
I have to overall disagree, because it has also been my experience that with certain people, they do work off of when you come to them calmly, you know, you'll get a good response. But then for the ones, when you talk to them calmly, they tap dance, divert, or they get, or they're the ones to get upset coming to them.
It could be several reasons why a person don't take responsibility.
No, we're talking about a person. We're talking about women, not a person. She is a person, but we're talking about a specific kind of person We're talking about a percentage of women, a high percentage of women. Now, obviously, just by the fact that this turned into a debate, it means that you women, you and Rhea, do not like to assume responsibility. Because Rhea, without realizing it, has already created an excuse, is because men come off too aggressive. But you're not dealing with a boy over here. You're dealing with a real man. That excuse itself validates the fact that you don't like to assume responsibility. I'm not talking to you, Sharon. I'm talking to Rhea. Alicia and Crystal, what did you think of Rhea's response that women don't like to assume responsibility excuse because men come across too aggressively?
I think men are supposed to be aggressive. That's their nature.
Well, she's teaching them tonight, huh?
I wouldn't want a man that wasn't aggressive. I mean, he's a lion.
Wow. And Rhea smiles. I guess this sister's teaching them something, and if they were smart, they would get out that notepads. This is what Crystal said?
No.
She seems to be in total opposition with your whole paradigm, Sharon. I believe that you may be able to learn something from her. I believe that all of the ladies on the call may be able to learn something from her that could be resourceful if you intend of getting a man of quality and keeping him. I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. What do you think about that, Kadar? Well, Kadar's going to act like Queen when Empress came on the court.
The sister is coming straight from the scriptures and giving a clear understanding. She knows her role. She knows her place. She understands that. And as well as the man, she acknowledges him as being the head. So, you know, that's plain and simple.
What you think about that, Shay? Shay J?
If somebody's wrong, they're just wrong. If you're wrong, you're wrong. That's how I see it.
No, that's too vague, man. We don't even know what you're talking about.
I'm saying, like she said, some women, I don't really know too many people of women that don't take responsibility for whatever wrong that they, wherever they're, you know, thinking that they have to be right about everything or that they're always right about something. I don't really know too many women that way. I do know some women who they are unapologetically who they are, brother.
Hold on. What does that mean? Whoa.
Unapologetically?
They are who they are unapologetically. That sounds like double talk to me.
No, it's
decipher
not.
That.
Well, what I'm saying is that some people are just straightforward about who they are. They
Stop. What do you mean, like clean like linen? When he's trying to be himself, you're trying to condemn him for it. But now you're turning around and say some people are straightforward.
I'm not taking it there either. What I am saying is when I said I don't know a whole lot of women who don't admit that they're wrong, right? They are unapologetically rude, you know. And they will tell you. I'm not talking about Mr. Lennon. No, I'm saying there are a lot of women that I do know who will admit to being, you know, just out of line. That's what I'm saying.
Let me ask you this. Now, were you wrong the way that you conduct yourself the other night on my call? That's what I want to know.
I kind of feel that, I must say I was wrong because I did it publicly, but you were interviewing me about some serious things that happened to me in my childhood, and I was sharing my story. So when Mr. Lennon came on and just started jumping into woman bashing, what that had to do with the topic, I don't know. If you re-roll this tape back, got back and listen to him go haywire, got to the point of the talking about the genociding of unborn children and saying that's all melanated. Well, he didn't even use the word melanated, the word all black women tribute. I that to be insulting. So eventually I did address it. I'm not gonna say I was right, because it takes two people to argue. So I'm gonna say I was equally wrong as he was. However, it was wrong, because it was done publicly, and yeah, out of pocket. But in the whole situation, he was also wrong. So wrong.
And so this is what I mean about accountability. Now you saw that? You saw that right there? I asked a simple question. Should have been a yes or no question. And this is what I mean about women not wanting to assume responsibility. I didn't ask anything about her. You see, but how she had to try and validate her being off based upon him. That is not assuming accountability.
That is
what the other person does has nothing to do with how you respond. And I tried to explain that the other night. And that is the gulf between women and men that I'm trying to make a point of and address. Instead of her just saying, hey, yeah, I was wrong. I shouldn't behave like that. Oh, yeah, he was wrong. And blah, blah, pointing the finger. And that's what I'm talking about, is what women do. They tap dance around the truth. But she couldn't just say, yeah, I was wrong.
But I
was he wrong?
I don't feel that I was wrong. Tata Don, I'm talking about some traumatic stuff that happened to me.
One person should never allow someone else to take, because when someone can get you that angry, they're also controlling you.
Come on.
I'm going to go back to look at the video. I did say that because I addressed him the way I did publicly, yeah, that was wrong. However, the situation to me was very, very, it was no need for that, because before he came on with that negative energy, the conversation wasn't going in that direction. And the only thing I really said is this: if you're that disgruntled, then maybe women is not what you need. Yeah, I was wrong for saying that. I didn't have to say that. However, I felt like I conducted myself in an appropriate manner, because I did not start yelling and screaming. I just said, look, maybe woman ain't for you. That's what I said. And then I said he was behaving like a child. I said that. I don't remember yelling and screaming.
Do you smoke a lot of marijuana? Because you seem to have a short-term memory loss.
I smoke weed at all. I don't drink. I don't use drugs. I don't.
What do you think of the sister's response? You see the example that I was talking about? And I find that a lot in women. So what about that, Rhea? Excuse me if I was overly aggressive and that provoked her to respond that way. If I did, forgive me. I didn't think that I was being overly aggressive when I asked her that question. So then if I wasn't, Rhea, then how do you justify her response?
Well, I mean, the way you were asking her is an example of how I was saying that men can be aggressive, because you didn't have to ask her, like, was she high on marijuana, you know? Mm-hmm. That was unnecessary.
What?
You were asking her, was she high or something, and is that why she, responded the way that she did? That was unnecessary, and that's an example.
No, that was after I asked her the question.
Okay.
Did you get that, Alicia? Did you get that, Crystal, when I initially asked her?
No, I did not get that. I didn't get it at all. No,
I don't know how you're receiving that, Rhea. I don't know where that's even. Did you get that, Jaijia? My initial question was were you high on marijuana? Asked her that. Obviously, you wasn't listening, Rhea, because I asked her that when she that she wasn't that way. When she say she didn't act disorderly, is when I asked her, were you high or something? Because what I recollect, you lost control, you were speaking very loudly. But initially, I just asked her, do you think that you was wrong? That was the only question. And when she said no, is when I asked her, was she high? And
Well, I
was that aggressive, even if I asked her that. That was sarcasm, not aggression.
Right.
I'm glad Rhea decided to come on the call, because people get to see her for who she really is, right? Expose the contention, right? So now we see right here, she exaggerate. And these type of women have a tendency, these are the kind of women that get men locked up over nothing. Now, she said that I was aggressive. Nowhere during the course of the conversation was I aggressive, but she exaggerate. And women do these type of things in court. It gets men locked up. It get restraining orders against them. Just an exaggeration because a woman is in her damn emotions, overly in her emotions, and it causes men problems. Now, the other thing here that you have to take note to is she's just basically playing favoritism for the woman's side because she's a woman. And this is why women like Rhea will end up alone with no man, because no man is going to tolerate this BS. No man that has any kind of iota of manhood left is going to tolerate this damn nonsense. And if this woman doesn't wake up, she will be alone for the remainder of her life, unless she's just booking penis appointments. You say women will assume responsibility, right?
Some do and some don't. You have
hold on. Would you say you assume responsibility?
Yes.
Okay. So with that being said, Kadar, were you here the other night when Clean was on the call?
Praise be to Most High, man.
Now, so you know, it so, is Ron, let me ask you this. Now, were you wrong the way that you conduct yourself the other night on my call? That's what I want to know.
I kind of feel that, I must say I was wrong because I did it publicly, but you were interviewing me about some serious things that happened to me in my childhood, and I was sharing my story. So when Mr. Leonard came on and just started jumping woman bashing, what that had to do with the topic, I don't know. If you re-roll this tape back and listen to him go haywire, got to the point of the talking about the genociding of unborn children and saying that's all melanated. Well, he didn't even use the word melanated, the word all black women tribute. I found that to be insulting. So eventually I did address it. I'm not going to say I was right because it takes two people to argue. So I'm going to say I was equally wrong as he was. However, it was wrong because it was done publicly and out of pocket. But in the whole situation, he was also wrong. So wrong.
And so this is what I mean about accountability. Now you saw that? You saw that right there?
I ran that back so you guys could see how Rhea tapped dance around the truth. See, she initially right now, when she was asked the question, tried to lie and said that I was aggressive with Shay and made an accusatory statement by saying, hey, you smoke marijuana. I was being sarcastic. That was after the initial question. When she denied the fact that she was wrong, then I asked her, do you smoke marijuana or something? Because you seem to have a short-term memory loss. And I know Rhea acknowledged that, but it just shows you the inaccountability in many women. And Rhea happens to be one of those women, which is why these kind of women will always have problems with real men. And instead of acknowledging her wrong, in turn, she'll tell the man, maybe you need to look at the self. Well, maybe you need to get a damn pet and prepare to die alone. I'm Kahan Tells a Doc, and this is The Truth Will Make You Mad. Now, you can like it, understand it, believe it or not. Now, get angry.